Hello, friends. It is Brian again, live from the old Charleston District Jail, and it is time to start sharing some stories of the things that I've experienced and the things that other people have experienced inside of this beautiful yet sad and depressing jail. Now, it has been an active night already. It was almost like as soon as the sun went down, as soon as I started that Facebook Live earlier, it was like the building came alive. Upstairs started getting a lot more noisy. You were hearing windows banging from upstairs, and we also started hearing what sounded like somebody pushing something across the ground upstairs. So I think the spirits know that I'm here because honestly, from what I've been told by many people, the spirits in this building like me being here. And I think it's because I respect them and I do not judge them for while they were here during their actual living phase of their life, now their afterlife. But we are currently in the morgue area. As far as I can tell, everything looks to be good with the live feed. Doesn't look to be chopping up, which is nice. So hopefully I can continue to do this throughout the night in different parts of the jail. I guess I'll be hanging out by the windows for most of the night. But one of the first things I ever experienced in this jail was about a year and a half ago, and it was down here on this bottom floor area. Now, I had never had anything happen to me before in this building. Usually when I talk to my people that are on tours, I tell my folks, I say, listen, if you're hoping for an experience tonight, the best way to experience anything is to walk in this building with an open heart and an open mind and just let it be. I actually had to tell myself that tonight before these Facebook Lives because I'm just so amped up to be here this evening. But the best way, open heart, open mind, allow the building to interact with you. Don't expect anything from this place. Don't expect things to pop out from corners. Just let things happen, because anytime I've had anything happen to me, it's always been when I've least expected it. So one of my first ever moments was down here on this bottom floor. There's an area, if you've ever been on a tour here at the jail, the last room we normally go into is going to be the back of the building, and it's pretty much the darkest room in the building on tours. I like to refer to that as the feel some type of way room, because normally if people are gonna feel some type of way, it's gonna be in that room. Sometimes we refer to it as the claustrophobic room. So my first ever night of giving tours for Bulldog, my first ever tour, we were in that back room and I remember talking and doing what I always do. I'll pan the room because I like to make my tours very personal to me. It's so much more than just giving you stories. I want to connect with each and every one of you. So as I'm looking around the room, trying to make eye contact in a dark room as best I can, looking at everybody, I see this lady and she's like this. She's leaned up against the wall and her hands in front of her face like this. I thought she cut herself. I ended up shining the flashlight over to her and I said, ma'am, are you okay? And I just look at her hand and her hand is very shiny. And whatever happened in that room, she was not a drinker. Some people do come into this building on tours with liquid spirits already in their bodies, but this lady was not a drinker. She got into that particular room, something came over her, and she just bleh, all over the floor. So when people ask me what kind of things happen in this building, it is anything from people passing out. We've had people throw up on tours. You had people get scratched inside this building. And again, nothing is evil inside here. The things that are here, you have to remember, they were here under the harshest conditions you can imagine as a human being, with improper nutrition, the elements from outside getting in the building, just improper care of a human being. So they suffered while they were here. They're choosing to interact with you in many different ways. Some people can't handle the way they try to interact with you. So that lady that night literally just lost her dinner all over the floor. I was the rookie at the time, so thank God I had a very busy night of tours. I think it was actually poor Will. I think it was Will up front. I remember going around the front going, hey Will, I gotta grab this next tour, but there's somebody that vomited on the bottom floor. Would you go grab that? Thanks. Everybody, follow me to the back. So yeah, sorry about that, Will, my bad. So I think it was Will back there. But down here on the bottom floor, I ended up walking from the back of the jail and I was making my way to the front of the building. Never had this feeling before, ever, being inside this jail. Usually the way I describe to it to most people, it's the feeling of like energy hitting your body. And it wasn't a cold sensation. It was very warm that day. I think it was, God, it must have been July or August. It was very hot outside. Walking from the back to the front, and as I'm walking down, get down to this one spot, I go to cross through the threshold of the doorway, and I just remember out of nowhere, you feel this just, oh, you feel this energy just hit your body out of nowhere. And it feels like you just ran up 10 flights of stairs, just like that. Or it feels like somebody put a weighted vest on your body. And I just remember feeling that. My friend was behind me at the time, my friend Kristen and Lindsay were with me. Lindsay, very sensitive to spirits. She can't really see things, but she feels when they're around. When that energy hit my body, I all of a sudden felt what felt like a huge stab in my back. What that was Lindsay. Lindsay felt what I just felt, punches me in the lower back, and she's like, I'm done, I'm out of this building. I've actually tried to talk her into coming back in this building since then. Lindsay has absolutely zero desire to come back in this place before. So my first ever experience was down here on the bottom floor, and it was feeling that heavy weight on my body, and it always just, it comes out of nowhere. You don't expect it, you don't feel the buildup of it, it's just there, sitting on top of your body. Now, everybody still hanging in over there? Everybody good? My candle person's now become my camera person, so. Catch me from my not fat side, right? Good, good, everybody's looking skinny there. All right, now, I'll share a little personal, very personal story with you. My grandmother is the most amazing grandmother ever. She trumps all grandmothers. Yes, I'm biased. But my grandmother sees things. She has always seen ghosts, seen spirits, and experienced things her entire life. They say when she was born, they described it as she was born with a white veil over her face. And that's basically symbolic of she has a gift. So my grandmother grew up on Franklin Street. The street in front of the jail is Magazine Street. Right next to it, you've got Franklin Street. So the jail shut down in 1939. My grandmother moved across the street in 1945. She was 8 years old when she moved over there. And she would always tell me stories as a little girl at 8 years old, because when the jail was shut down, this place was vacant, so it was pretty much used by the city for random storage. Her and her girlfriends used to play inside of the jail as children. You know, I'm playing inside here as a big child at 39 years old, but her and her little friends used to always play inside the jail as kids. So I started working at Bulldog in May of 2019. I started training to give tours here at the jail in April of 2019. I wanted to bring my grandmother here because she had not stepped foot inside this jail since 1945. And I bring her in the building. I gave her no history outside of what she already knew about the jail because I wanted her to have a very genuine experience. Now, I was here with Joy, who you saw in the videos last night. Joy, she's an amazing woman. She pretty much kidnapped my grandmother for an hour and a half and walked her around the building. A couple things happened that day. One, I saw my grandmother cry for the first time ever. I've never seen my grandma cry. Why did she cry? We got down to the bottom floor. There is a room in here. It's the isolation room, basically a torture chamber in that room. My grandmother, I was standing in the kitchen. She walks down the hallway. She gets to the doorway of this room and she stops. She won't go past the threshold of the door. She ends up putting her hand up on the wall, and I'm standing behind her and I look over and I just see her kind of put her head down like that. And I said, are you okay? And I remember she just turns around and looks at me, and she's got tears running down her eyes. And take in mind, never have I seen my grandmother cry. When my grandfather passed away, I don't remember my grandmother crying. She's just old school like that. So I say, what's wrong? And she goes, I cannot go in this room. I can't be in this room. I asked her, what do you see? She goes, in that corner of the room over there, there's this man. He's sitting on the ground. He's curled up in the fetal position. And it looks like he has just been beaten. His clothes are ripped. There's blood everywhere. And he's just curled up and he's in pain. She could not go inside of that room. More things from Grandma's experience here. Everybody still good over there? Okay. Hello, whoever's over there right now. I can't see your names, but I'll wave hello. On the second floor, a lot of you don't see this during our regular tours because we only have so much time to bring you through the building. And when you do investigations, you would have a chance to go in there and see this room. But there's a room we call the graffiti room. The graffiti room is actually a room where inmates have etched and scratched things into the walls of the jail. You'll see names up there. You'll see years they were here. Some folks have actually drawn ships into the walls. There's also tally marks. Most people think tally marks is how many days they've been at the jail. What it actually was counting down the days to their court appearance, to their trial. So I took Grandma in that room. Now, a lot of people will ask me when I give tours, Brian, does anything ever follow you home? Yes. It does not happen all the time, but sometimes it does happen. In that room, we're standing there. This is about 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Feel that breeze? And the door slamming upstairs. Yeah, they're fun tonight. Everything good?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, just checking on you over there. So my grandma, we're standing in that room and she's in mid-sentence and she just looks at me. I can tell she's not looking at me. She's looking right past me. So I say, what do you see? She goes, right behind you, standing up against the wall, looking at you, I see two boys, about 14 to 15 years of age. There's an African-American boy and there's a white boy standing there looking at you. To me, I can't see that stuff. You know, I've said before, I don't have a gift. I'm lucky enough to experience what I've experienced in this jail. So I just said, should I be concerned that they're staring at me? She said, no. They want you to know. Now, take in mind, this was before I started working here officially. She said, they want you to know that they're ready for you here at the jail. You think that sound, I mean, to me, somebody looking at you and saying, there's two spirits standing there at the wall and they're ready for you. To me, that kind of made me a little bit nervous, but she assured me that they were ready for me because they knew I was coming to work at this building. They knew I was here to share their story. I wasn't here to judge them. I wasn't here to look down on them. I was here to share their history. So a few moments later, I'm standing against the wall. I love touching walls in this building. If you've ever been in here with me before, you'll see me kind of just touch my hand on certain parts of the building and just kind of feel the building. So I'm standing there in that same room. I've got my hand on the wall, just feeling. And my grandma, again, comes up. She's standing behind the iron door. And she gives me the look again. I'm like, what? She goes, they're right behind you right now. And so me being casual, I was like, should I be concerned at all? She goes, no. They like you. And they're going to protect you while you're here at the jail. So I was like, okay. That made me feel better. Now, fast forward 1 week later, I'm at Grandma's house, sitting in her grandma room, just having a little chit chat, doing what we do. And in mid conversation, Grandma stops and gives me that look again. And it's that look again of not looking at me. She's looking right past me. And I said, why are you giving me that look in your house? She goes, well, I didn't want to say anything. And I said, well, you're staring at me and you're grinning, so please tell me what you're looking at. And she goes, do you remember that blonde boy from the jail? I said, yeah. She goes, he's standing right behind you. And so I again said, should I be concerned? And she goes, no. He is there to protect you in that jail, to make sure nothing bad happens to you. So yes, sometimes things do follow us home from the jail. A lot of the times when you're leaving a tour, we tell some people to look at the building and say respectfully, you stay in your home, I'm going to go to my home. I appreciate you and I appreciate what you're trying to share with me, but I'm gonna go to my place, you stay at yours, please. I've had a couple of other weird things happen to me at my house. I'll share those as the night goes along, but that is one of my many stories that I'm gonna be sharing tonight here on our wonderful Facebook Live at Bulldog Tours. Again, seriously, from the bottom of my heart and everybody at Bulldog, thank you so much for watching these videos, sharing these videos, because we do love the history of this city. We do love sharing the things that happen here. And me, I am so passionate. I don't know if you can tell or not, but I love this building. I love the things that are still here. I like to share their stories and let people know about them. Because again, not a lot of them were guilty of the crimes they committed. They were innocent folks that suffered and died here in this jail. So I appreciate you watching. We're gonna do another Facebook Live about an hour from now, and I'll share some more stories. If you got any questions, throw them in the comments, and I'll try to write them down and get to them on the next video we do in about an hour. But again, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys very, very soon.